Welcome, everyone, to Noche NBA. A Latin theme is the backdrop to tonight's festivities. And tonight it'll be the Oklahoma City Thunder going up against the Los Angeles Lakers here in Staples Center. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony as well as Brent Berry. And we'll be catching up a bit from the sideline with David Aldridge. D.A., take it away.
Well, it took 5 long months, but Anthony Davis's trade request was finally granted. And now he has a new start in Los Angeles alongside LeBron James. The Lakers now boast 2 top 10 players. Kevin, this is a team with legitimate championship aspirations.
And D.A., that's the standard for the Lakers organization. Thanks for that report. And look now at a few years' worth of data. Some of the assist numbers under the microscope for Rondo.
The drop in his assists over the past few years have made him more of a one-dimensional player offensively. He needs to get that passing element back in his game, and that'll make life a lot more difficult for opposing defenses.
So here's Oklahoma City's starting group. Gallinari and Adams, the combo out front. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Chris Paul. And it's Dort in at the three. And for the Lakers, LeBron and Davis, the incredible forward pair. Avery Bradley is out there with Green, and it's McGee in at the five, roaming the paint. You know, Greg, for the Thunder fans, hard to see their star power dwindle, but they got a lot in return.
Yeah, but the Thunder were capped out. They hadn't made it past the first round in 3 years, and in exchange for Paul George, they got one of the richest trade packages in league history.
And it's Paul missing. And so Green will bring it up for Los Angeles. And it's James missing. Davis against Gallinari. Paul looking around. Here's Gilgeous Alexander.
Unselfish play of Chris Paul there. Has a knack for knowing when to get his guys when they're wide open.
Poked loose. And that's out of bounds. The Lakers will retain possession. Davis kicks to Bradley. Lakers working the ball around now. James outside. Just 5 to shoot. They get a hand on it. Here's Davis. And they'll turn it over. Could not get off a shot. 24-second violation. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. Paul against Bradley. Here's Paul. He's coming off a 28-point game against Utah.
And a gigantic game for him at the free throw line. He was an instigator, drawing a ton of contact and really just hunting for the whistle.
And Gilgeous Alexander showing just how difficult he can be to guard at times.
Pass to LeBron. Unloads from 13. It's hauled in by Adams.
Yeah, a little bit surprising he hasn't connected on at least one of his 3 shots yet, but he's going to keep shooting.
The 11-footer, and there's another one for the Thunder.
Just love to see Chris Paul operate in that area. Slows himself down. Great balance. That's one of his many strengths.
Now McGee. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. LeBron can't get it to go.
I don't think the defense does enough out there to bother him. I think that one's all on him. Just a flat-out miss.
Paul outside. Bradley against Gallinari. There's JaVale McGee with the rebound.
Well, with his touch from mid-range, Kevin, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring. It took him a while, but he finally gets one to fall.
Paul outside. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Let's a floater go. That one good for 2. Gilgeous Alexander's got 6 points. With the playoffs around the corner, Brent, some teams already making vacation plans. Talk about the disappointment that those kinds of teams are feeling right now.
Yeah, you start the beginning of training camp with ideas of wanting to play into the postseason, and you know the realization of that goal is not going to be met. And what you want to do is remember your opportunity as a player, Kevin, to go out and still compete. You might not be back with the team that you're playing the end of the season with, the last 10 games. Maybe you're somewhere else. But there are teams, as we've always said, still watching you. And so don't ever get away from the idea of the competition as the season winds down.
They always say the eye in the sky doesn't lie. Everything is on tape, right?
I mean, yeah, and they are assessing how it is that you approach that, because you show your stripes when things are not going well. What kind of character do you have?
Dwight Howard, he's checked in for the Lakers. And a switcher also for Oklahoma City.
What's up?
Ferguson's checked in. And the GOAT conversation. LeBron has said his motivation is to surpass Michael Jordan as the greatest of all time. Gray, what do you think he needs to do to bolster his case?
I think for the naysayers, the obvious answer is more rings. You look at the other numbers, including those 8 consecutive finals appearances, LeBron is in the discussion.
And Howard with this stuff.
I think that's Dwight Howard's favorite play. He loves going up for the oop. Outstanding chemistry between him and his teammate there.
Paul dishes to Adams. Kicks it to Gallinari. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Well, when Danilo Gallinari came into the NBA, Brent, he was just a catch-and-shoot type player. But he's so much more than that now.
Well, I think with the way the league has changed with the three-point shot and Gallinari's ability to do that, he's gotten a lot smarter about picking his spots when the pump fake can drive in and draw some contact.
No good on the free throw.
His versatility, at least for Gallinari, is something that's so important for coaches to utilize. He's capable of stretching the floor the way he shoots it.
Looking at who's out there now for the Lakers. Kyle Kuzma's checked in for James. Kentavious Caldwell Pope comes in for Green. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Avery Bradley. And he's good on the second. So it's the Lakers now. 4-point game. Rondo kicks to Kuzma. The pass to Davis. Caldwell Pope outside. Down to 5 on the shot clock. That one misses. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. Gallinari outside. Rondo with the steal. Here's Howard, and it's Howard finishing it off.
Yeah, there's no excuse right there for not covering one of the guys on the floor, and that's Rondo around the rim where he can score.
Now here's Noel. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 8 points a game. Back to Schroeder. 5 on the clock. Pass to Gallinari. They get it again, and Muscala kicks to Ferguson. Second chance shot, and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
And the first few seasons in the NBA, not an easy time for Terrence Ferguson. The young wings have their ups and downs, but the franchise still very much believes in his talent.
And he makes the first. And with Ferguson, the fans can be hard on him. They're expecting more. But, Greg, it's going to take time for him.
You know, Ferguson has already made big strides with his defense. The shot and consistency will come. But the fans will have to be patient with him.
The Lakers making a switch here. Morris has checked in. And the Lakers with possession here. Trailing by 4. Rondo finds Caldwell Pope and stolen by Diallo. And they're running. A slam dunk by Diallo.
Great effort, and gets in a little razzle dazzle at the end of that one.
Yeah, why not? Show a little creativity, get inside, move that ball around, just make sure you score.
Now here's Howard. taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. Good work there as it goes.
A good decision right there from Dwight. Excellent awareness on that particular play.
Pass to Noel. Diallo with it. He averages a bit over 6 points a game.
He just powered that one down.
One of the game's top dunkers. Lakers trail by six. Passes it to Howard. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City.
And it's going to come down to effort tonight. Last time they met each other, they were demolished on the boards, and that rebounding difference led to a sizable loss.
Well, let's see if the lesson was learned from that loss. If they come out with the same type of effort, they can expect a similar result here.
Now, here's Schroeder. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against Utah.
His passing, another high point in that game. He made sure it wasn't all about him. He wanted to get his teammates involved.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Morris passes to Howard. Just five on the clock. Here's Caldwell Pope. And it's Noel with the rebound.
Well, the D's so tight on him, it makes him alter his shot. And an easy chance turns into a tough one because the defense is swarming.
Traditionally, that's how you want to finish the break, right at the rim.
Yeah, anything other than a layup in that situation, probably disappointing. Had numbers, took advantage.
And that one misses. Out to the wing. Caruso, the pass to Kuzma. Here's Rondo, and he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And the foul goes against Oklahoma City.
And Rondo playing with great energy right now, putting the defense in some very difficult spots.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
Numbers this year at the line below 70, so when he's getting to the line, not nearly as effective as you'd like.
And the first one at the line is good.
Yeah, when Rondo gets motivated, and we've seen that now for a good stretch, he's as valuable as it gets.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. 7 seconds left here in the first quarter. Here's Schroeder. It's stolen by Rondo. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Thunder lead by four. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. There's a great friendship between Melo, LeBron, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Paul. And Chris talked about where all that started.
It's been a sort of long relationship, you know, and obviously me, Bron, Melo, D. Wade have all really gotten really close. And that stems from the time with the Olympics, USA teams, and then just sharing a lot of the same likes and values and having kids and family and different things like that.
And you see that a lot nowadays, star players developing friendships and GA spending time with each other off the floor.
Yeah, some people hate it because they want that bad blood you used to see, but no reason you have to hate someone to really compete against them.
Welcome back to Noche Latina, celebrating the Latin culture and their love for the game of basketball. It just keeps growing. What stands out to you from Oklahoma City in this one?
Well, they've been aggressive from the beginning, particularly on the offensive end.
Well, if they wanted to start well, this would be it. They seized momentum right away, and they just didn't let it go in that quarter.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. So for Oklahoma City right now, we've got Dennis Schroeder, Mike Muscala out there at Nerlens Noel. And it's Diallo in at the shooting guard position. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Brent, when it comes to moving around in tight quarters without a lot of space, who's the quickest player that you have seen in a half-court set this year?
Still remarkable to watch where it is that Kyrie Irving can get to on the floor in any sort of possession. It's like he could take, you know, 50 dribbles in a phone booth and find a way out of it, spinning around and finding gaps within the defense.
What a handle.
But it's not his handle with just the one hand, right, Kevin? About he has an idea of, after he does the moves around the traffic, when he gets into the basket, multiple ways of finishing, much like Rod Strickland, who's a tremendous finisher in his days years and years ago. Kyrie's got a lot of that in his game.
Good on both.
With Schroeder, it's all about speed. He just changes direction and shifts into another gear, Kevin. That's where his advantage lies.
Now here's Rondo. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
And the pass to Muscala. Now Noel. He kicks it to Schroeder. Oh, he's going up for the alley-oop here. And it's Noel missing.
Yeah, and that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
Yeah, you can see when it's that close, players react. He's just, oh, man, we just missed that one. Maybe they'll get another chance at it.
So they take the lead. And it's 6 points for Rajon Rondo.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Schroeder against Rondo. And Rondo sends it back.
An average shot blocker. The key for Rondo is to know when to leap up for those rejections, that time using length.
And the shot goes down.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling down.
Here's Dort, following the basket by Kyle Kuzma. And it's Noel missing. Guys, this offense very effective.
And guys, the defense has been no match. They've just picked them apart. And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
And first time out of the game called for Oklahoma City.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
Big group substitution here for the Lakers. JaVale McGee's checked in for Howard. Anthony Davis comes in for Markieff Morris. LeBron's checked in for Kyle Kuzma. And it's Green in for Rajon Rondo. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Adams, he's checked in for Nerlens Noel. Alinari comes in for Muscala. Gilgeous Alexander's checked in for Diallo. And Paul's subbed in for Dennis Schroeder. Here's James, following the basket by Chris Paul. Davis, the pass to LeBron. Back to Davis. Six to shoot. Got a piece of it. Here's Dort. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. He dishes it to Paul. Fires from 14. And Davis pulls it down. Lakers leading by three. Caruso looking for an opening to the inside, and Davis can't get it to go. And so it's Gallinari with it. He'll bring it up for the Thunder. And after this one, they're home against Minnesota. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
Now Gallinari at that size can do a little bit of everything, and I like to see him dishing the rock.
Here's Caruso. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. And the shot is good. And that's now 7 points for LeBron.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Paul passes to Adams. Now, Gilgeous Alexander, guarded by McGee. 5 to shoot. Back to Adams. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by McGee. And now you see the 2K leaderboard. Not only have these teams caused a lot of turnovers over the last 10 games, but they've scored off them as well. In third, the Lakers.
Just a terrific job over this stretch of forcing turnovers and capitalizing. They'd love to continue that trend.
From deep, Gallinari gets it to go from beyond the arc. Gallinari's got it all tied up now for the Thunder. For Los Angeles, they've gotten all but one of their 7 shots in the second quarter to drop. Pretty impressive. And it's Davis missing. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter.
Well, we keep talking a lot about Anthony Davis and the fact that when he was a young player, he played the point guard position and then all of a sudden grew like 60 inches to play center position. You see that skill set show up now and again, but really what you're seeing now about AD is his maturity in the game, finding spots on the floor where he can absolutely be dominant and control any kind of offensive possession from wherever he is on the floor.
And yes, it's good. And it's 6 points for Gallinari.
Nice swing action there. Gallo, he simply squares up and rises to the occasion.
Back to James. Pass to Caruso. Trying to find Davis. He's got it now. Paul passes to Adams. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
Well, not many times does Adams get his number called for plays like that, but the oop there looked good.
And at Kentucky, Davis mostly an interior player, but he maintained, Brent, all along. He was capable of more than he showed in college.
There's no question about his skill set, and in the NBA, the opportunity, along with the transition of the NBA game, and especially the center position, he seems to be coming along at the appropriate time to show all of his wares off, Kevin.
Now here's James. 29 points for him last game against Houston. Green kicks to Caruso. And the 3 off target.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
It's blocked. Now here's LeBron. He's covered closely. Gallinari against Davis. Gilgeous Alexander, good.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Giving up a run here, can they turn it around?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through 2 or 3 iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Morris is checked in for JaVale McGee. Kyle Kuzma comes in for Davis. Caldwell Pope, he's checked in for Green. And it's Avery Bradley in for Alex Caruso. Now here's James. 7 points in the game. Here's Morris, and Morris throws it down.
Well, there's no way that LeBron James is not going to come in and dictate the tempo of this game. Just keeps his eyes up and drops a nice dime there.
Basket counts. Diallo's got 6 points.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
James dishes to Morris. Inside. Yep, it goes, and the Oklahoma City lead is cut down to just 4 points with a bucket from Bradley.
A bonus when Avery Bradley is finding ways to score inside. He's got to keep working on his interior game.
Here's Schroeder. No good on the three. And it's Kuzma with the ball for the Los Angeles Lakers. Bradley, no one around him. Nice open look, but it's no good. Ferguson, the pass to Muscala. Now here's Schroeder. His scoring totals are something to take note of. He's averaging over 19 points a game. Fires the three, and that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. And that's it for the first half of action in what's been a very close game here. It's the Thunder up by 4. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Chris, you guys shot a great percentage in the first half, but still a tight game. What do you think's causing that?
I think right now we're playing at their tempo. You know, we need to pick up the pace. Defend, rebound, run, and pick up the pace a little bit.
And defense starts that pace. Thanks, Chris. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings to each and every one of you watching at this very moment. I'm Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is here. Shaq is here. One half is behind us. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
A competitive matchup for Oklahoma City in the first quarter. They got their lead up to as many as 8 points in the opening period. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output for both teams, and they still find themselves in a good position at the half. Kenny, let's get your take on Oklahoma City.
I was surprised on how comfortable they seemed here on the road. The hostile crowd, that didn't bother them at all. And I want to see if they can keep that up in the second half.
Shaq, your take on the Lakers.
I think it was their passing that's kept them in the game. You can see it in their assist numbers. They were very, very unselfish. The ball moving from side to side, guys making good cuts. It's enabled them to create a lot of chances. As long as they stay on the same page and keep working together, they got a great chance to take control of this game.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks goodbye, for folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game that's been so far. Lakers trail by 4. Green and LeBron at the 2 and the 3. JaVale McGee is out there with Davis, and it's Bradley in at the guard position. That's the group starting the second half for Frank Vogel.
Great work by the team there to find AD. They make eye contact, and the rest of that is history.
Paul kicks to Gilgeous Alexander. Adams trying to free himself up. Gilgeous Alexander, good. Gilgeous Alexander's got 12.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
The three from LeBron. Thunder with the rebound. Here's Dort. Knocks down the three ball. And the Thunder lead by 7.
It's kind of like playing in the rec league. Little to no defense on that possession. And the easiest three-pointer you can imagine.
Gallinari against James. And they come right back with their own 3 points. He's got 10.
Now, over time, LeBron James just becomes more and more capable of more things. That time, the jumper goes.
Still playing at an MVP level, LeBron James, the greatest player of his generation, and some would argue, of all time. We can't take for granted what we've been able to witness.
And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Left side, Davis. And Adams sends it back.
Well, he can be intimidating. Steven Adams, such a big frame down there and great timing on that block.
And it's Paul missing.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
And now in his mid-30s, LeBron showing no sign of slowing down.
Man, his dedication to training and really maintaining his body, second to none. Alongside his prodigious athleticism, it seems that's made a huge difference.
And the first one drops.
Well, as good as AD already is, to think that there's still upside to his game, it's really remarkable. Athletic, talented, and continues to work hard to maximize his talents.
Dwight Howard, he's checked in for JaVale McGee. And so he's able to get one of two. You often hear about players talk about their favorite spot to fire from on the floor. How much of an effect does that really have, a favorite shooting spot?
Most of the time, Kevin, what you're talking about is star guys, because they're the ones who ultimately, in any given possession, the coach is trying to find that guy in that spot to do something. What happens throughout the course of a year is when that player has the ball there, everybody else knows what to do.
Right.
Like, the player knows what he's going to do, right, Kevin? Because he's the star player. But everybody around gets comfortable with the options and where it is that he goes. If he goes right, if I slide right, I'm going to get the three. If he goes left, he's spinning back, I might move towards the top of the key. So the familiarity of not just the player, but the players around the player, that's where you can make it happen.
That's interesting. Now, here's James. He's got 10. Ripped away. Paul with the ball, now guarded by Bradley. Second shot opportunity, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It's going to be on Avery Bradley.
Yeah, you just have to be careful when you're guarding Chris Paul. He's very, very clever getting to the free throw line.
The Thunder have missed two free throws in the game, going 5 for 7.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
The first free throw is good.
At this point in his career, Chris Paul is all about trying to get that elusive championship. We'll play whatever role it takes to get that mission done.
Rajon Rondo is checked in for Los Angeles. Ferguson's checked in for Oklahoma City. And Paul drills both of them.
Now you could tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
James dishes to Davis. Back to LeBron. Pass to Davis. Hits the jump hook. Davis has got 5 points in the quarter. The Thunder leading by 7. Passes it to Ferguson. Now the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Clock at 6. 14 feet away. Rebounded by Howard. Howard's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Rondo passes to LeBron. Again, Los Angeles.
Well, it looks like he's got just one of those good feels tonight. That means trouble for the opponent.
Here's Ferguson. From the elbow, and there's the foul. It's on Steven Adams. That is his first foul of the game. And Los Angeles with some changes. Kyle Kuzma's checked in for James, and it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope in for Bradley. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Noel's checked in for Steven Adams. Muscala comes in for Gallinari. Diallo, he's checked in for Shea Gilgeous-Alexander. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Paul. Outside, Davis kicks to Howard. Here's Rondo. Howard trying to free himself up. Rondo, no good.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Now, here is Muscala. No points in the game yet for him. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Davis. And that'll be his third foul so far. Los Angeles making a switch here. Morris has checked in. Here's Diallo. That one a little long.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Yeah, see the coach? He's got that frown on his face. I think we know why. Not a high percentage look.
Now, here's Kuzma. 9 points in the game so far. Morris, left side. Rebound by Muscala.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
Caldwell Pope on the wing. He's guarded by Diallo. And that'll be Oklahoma City's ball as it goes out of bounds.
Now that's two teammates who need to reintroduce themselves to one another, not on the same page.
Alex Caruso, he's checked in for Los Angeles. The Thunder leading by 5. We've got 1:55 left in the third. Plenty of daylight on that shot. Schroeder's got 5.
Well, Schroeder likes to drive first, now establishing the shoot-first confidence. Love watching him rise up immediately after the catch.
Now here's Caldwell Pope. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Count it.
Terrific effort from him really all night. Yet despite his supreme marksmanship, we're still operating at a deficit.
And positionless basketball, all the rage. And Kyle Kuzma really fits that mold. Is he a 3? Is he a 4? I don't know, but he gets buckets.
Now here's Noel. Sinks the 3-pointer. Diallo's got the lead up to 9 now for the Thunder.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on Schroeder.
Caldwell Pope feeling it out a bit. Pass to Kuzma over Diallo. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2.
Plays with such a fearlessness. Kuzma is terrific at staying engaged and forcing the issue.
Los Angeles shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
And when you look at that free throw percentage on the season, they're right around 73%.
Free throw good, Kuzma. JaVale McGee's checked in for Markieff Morris. Both free throws good for Kuzma. There's 49 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. And here's Schroeder. He's got 5. Pass to Muscala. Now Noel. Just 5 to shoot. To the middle. Schroeder. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Schroeder's got 7 points.
And Schroeder did not even have to think twice about that shot. This young man simply devours these chances inside.
The shot and game clock separated by 4. Passes to Caruso. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Here's Kuzma. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. The Lakers have been coming through at the charity stripe. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts. The first one falls. That one misses.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Ferguson kicks it over to Schroeder. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
In perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the 3-point line.
And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Thunder lead by 11. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. So for Oklahoma City right now, Ferguson out there with Muscala. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. Then there's Nerlens Noel. And it's Diallo in at the two. Back to Schroeder. From deep. The rebound by Caldwell Pope. And here's Caldwell Pope. He brings it up for Los Angeles. 11-point game.
Yeah, liking the vision there from Caldwell Pope, looking to get his guys going when they're open.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. For the Thunder, Gallinari comes in for Muscala. And Shai Gilgeous-Alexander subbed in for Diallo. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Billy Donovan talking to his team. His point to them was that they put themselves in a position to succeed and that this is their game to lose. So he needs to see full concentration out of every guy on the court to finish this one off. Kevin?
Thank you, David. For three, Caldwell Pope. Gallinari with the rebound. Gallinari's got his fourth rebound in this one.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Out to Kuzma. Jacks up a three. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. Schroeder with the ball. It's stolen by Green. Last break, the Lakers. Here's Kuzma. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
And this is what Kuzma can do. When he's got it going, you've got to keep getting him opportunities.
The pass to Ferguson. Schroeder looking around. High, arcing shot, and he gets it back. Danny battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. Schroeder's got the lead up to 11 now for the Thunder. And the Lakers call time here.
And as things present themselves throughout a game, teams have to adapt on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team, Greg.
And the Lakers with some changes. Davis is checked in for Kyle Kuzma. James comes in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And Bradley's subbed in for Alex Caruso. James, the pass to Bradley. Back to LeBron. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And LeBron enjoys fooling the D right there, tricked them, got them in the air, and then gets himself to the free throw line.
And he knocks down the first one.
When you talk to opposing coaches and how they scheme for LeBron James, the amazing thing is they talk about how he sees every facet of the game, not just what he needs to run, but how it is that he can make it difficult for opposing offenses.
Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Count it. Good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Lakers trail by 12. Outside, Davis. The dish now to James. He kicks it to Bradley. From 11 feet away, Los Angeles with another miss. The Thunder leading by 12. Gallinari attacking. Davis with some nice deep.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
A fader. James, no good.
You get a feeling that he made that much more difficult than he had to. No reason why he had to fade away on that jumper.
To the left side wing. The shot's good from Paul.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Pass to Davis. It's blocked. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. From the inbound, buries it despite the hat. Terrific play. We'll have a chance for one more. That one on Gallinari.
You take a look at Anthony Davis and his frame and think about his rookie year coming in so thin and moved around a lot by bigger, stronger players in the post. No longer the case, as he's put on a ton of muscle to that frame and continues to grow in the strength area along with his confidence. That's helped him out a lot.
And that one falls for Davis. And after just one season at Kentucky, the slight build of Davis was a concern in the NBA, and question was, would his body hold up?
Well, he's answering the question to some degree, Kevin, knowing that it wasn't a one-year process to get stronger and to put on that kind of weight. That just comes with physical maturity. Anthony Davis doing a better job of avoiding places where he might get injured, expanding his game to the perimeter, and hopefully some of those things pay off for his longevity for his career.
James finds Davis. Yes, it's James picking up the assist.
And what a turnaround from the first half. I mean, he's been incredible here in the second half.
Now here's Paul. Gallinari wide open. Gets the three-pointer to fall. And the Thunder lead by 12.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
McGee dishes to James. And James throws it down hard.
Sometimes LeBron just likes to take it all out on the rim, that time on display.
Over to the left wing. Here's Dort, covered by LeBron. He can't get that one.
And it's still a close game. I mean, despite the fact that they've struggled to compete on the board.
When you give Anthony Davis those kind of looks, he's going to make you pay.
So it's the Thunder now. They've led by as many as 14 points. Shoots from 12. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Davis has got his fourth rebound in this one. Lakers working the ball around now. On the wing, James. And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's his first foul. And here's Bradley from three. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron.
How about Bradley stepping up in the leadership role, and a huge one there.
Paul with the ball, now guarded by Bradley. Ball against Bradley. Pass to Dort. Four on the clock. Shoots over McGee. Dort misses.
And his lateral quickness really allows him to stay in front of the shooter there and challenge the shot.
Talk about versatility on offense a lot, but how about on defense? And he takes pride in making an impact down there.
And with that, the Thunder lead is cut down to just three in the basket from Anthony Davis. Bradley against Paul. To the paint, here's Adams. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
How about Steven Adams coming through? Give him a chance.
And so James will bring it up for the Lakers. 102 left in the fourth quarter. And the dunk by James.
LeBron James, one of the best ever to do it.
Oklahoma City's gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. Paul against Davis. Paul passes to Adams. It's stolen by Davis. Jumps up, and James throws it down hard.
Whoa, the nerves on this guy.
Not backing down from this moment here. When the game is close, he kicks it up a notch.
They'll be trying to take as much time off the clock as they can.
Exactly. Expect to see longer possessions from this point on.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Outstanding job by AD to get close to the basket, get the ball in great position, and force the defense to resort to fouling him.
He knocks down the clutch free throw. So both free throws good that time. That puts him ahead.
Getting it done at the line as he usually does. And that could be huge in a tight game like this one.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. They're trailing by one. 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
And usually you want to go for the 2-for-1 here to maximize the clock.
And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, LeBron James.
And tell you what, he's worked very hard to get himself in good position throughout the course of this game. And that comes across in his shooting percentage. He's hit over half his shots from the field. And that's not because he got hot as much as it's because of the effort he put in to get himself open.
30 seconds left in the fourth. Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. They're behind by one. 29 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Defense! Here's Paul. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. McGee with the block and an intentional foul right there.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game out.
As he doesn't get the first one to fall, trying to focus now on the second.
And such an important contributor to his team's success over the years. It's amazing that Green was a second round pick and coming out of a big school at that.
That's off as well, so he misses both. Here's Paul. To the wing on the left. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's off from three. So it's Los Angeles taking the W in a close one. What a show they put on here at home tonight.
I mean, these are those games that feel so great to win, and really, it's like a knife in the gut to lose. You got to love being on edge of your seat and just wondering what's going to happen. How is this thing going to play out?
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Anthony, tell us the focus for the team coming into the game tonight.
Well, you know, before we started the game, you know, Coach came in and told us that we knew what we had to do. You know, we were trying to stop a lot of their actions, and, you know, our biggest focus for the game was guard the ball. That's what we did, coming out of that timeout and never looked back.
And it led to a win. Thank you for your time, Anthony. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.